Reason is God's crowning gift to man. My name is John Carmassi. I'm a detective of Los Angeles Police Department. Usually I work on crimes, homicide, but today is a bit different. I received a mail envelope from the group. They asked me to investigate on a murder that happened in another town. I have no jurisdiction in another town, but they asked the local police to give me all the clues about that homicide. The victim was an 82-year-old woman. Her name was Madeline Taylor, a normal woman, a normal past. She lived with her granddaughter, Jennifer, a normal teenager, 17 years old, a cheerleader with a normal love story with a college quarterback. The alibi of Jennifer was okay. She was out of town for a football match.
You live your life between tort and crime. You're the sad, sad bride. You're the sad bride. Blow the four little drops. Every day you die.
The crime scene was clean, well clean. The local police removed all the clues. But they gave me the murder weapon, a steel knife. The group sent me here because they know I have a gift or a curse. Sometimes I can see. I have visions of what happened. I can't really explain. It's a sort of black and white movie, and for me, I just have to touch or see something. I'm scared about it, and they leave me exhausted. I touched the knife, and I saw everything. The victim. The hand. The ring. A school. I reported to the group what I saw in my visions. It was something evil, satanic. I saw demons, a blonde girl, a couple, and a hand with a knife, and a school ring. A couple of days ago, Michael Austin was arrested. He was a satanist. Jennifer Taylor, the granddaughter of the victim, had a hidden love story with him. She officially was with a quarterback. But she loves the guys with something evil and started a story with Michael. She came the night before the crime to his room and he stole the key of the house. Then he went to Jennifer's house. He entered and the old woman, almost totally deaf, didn't hear him enter in her house. and he killed her. It was not for money, it was a sort of satanic rite. He said that voices in his mind asked him to kill her, to sacrifice the old woman. Maybe, with a good lawyer, he will sentence her for a year in a mental asylum. Michael has voices in his mind. I have visions in my mind. Will I become crazy like him? Can I become a danger for my friends? My mind burning, and I have only one way to stop it, and it's another wrong thing, I know it. The group said me that they could help me. I need to think about it.